other question is, what is NetConf?
Sure. So NetConf is an IETF standard network configuration protocol. And so that's where NetConf come from. It's often coupled with Yang. So you'll hear NetConf Yang. And what Yang is another standard for writing data models. And the primary models that you use with Yang would be network models, right? So a data model for an interface or an ACL. And so what NetConf is it's kind of a modern programmatic way to communicate with your network devices. And an easy example for this is to kind of correlate it to things that folks should generally know. And so for years, we've had SNMP. Right? SNMP is a programmatic way to talk to network devices. NetConf and Yang are kind of the evolution of what we've always had with SNMP, but solving some of the complaints or challenges that SNMP had related to performance, security, transactions, batch information as it goes through. And so I sometimes describe NetConf and Yang as kind of the next generation of SNMP protocol on that side. So if you understand kind of where SNMP is, then the basic functions, the reasons you would use SNMP, similar to what you would use NetConf for. What's nice about NetConf, though, is it was kind of designed not just for operational information, which is what SNMP is most often used for, right, is gathering traps and counters and things. NetConf was also designed to be very effective to do configuration of devices as they go through. And so with NetConf, you can very efficiently and effectively send configuration details and configure your device through the programmatic interface that is NetConf as it goes in. You can also gather operational details about how well the network device is going and get telemetry information as it goes through. NetConf is a protocol that runs kind of leverages SSH. And so we use SSH to connect to a device with CLI. And SSH handles the authentication, the encryption, kind of the transport over the wire pieces. And then once we connect with SSH, typically we send CLI commands. NetConf uses SSH to do the authentication and the transport over the wire. But once we've connected with NetConf, now rather than sending CLI commands, we send what are called XML payloads for RPCs or remote procedure calls. And so with NetConf, we would send a request for some information, and then the device would send that information back. And our communication to the device and the communication from the device would all be kind of packaged up as XML. And the reason it's XML is because as a data format, XML is very easy for developers or applications to consume and know exactly what it is that's in there. And so if you ask for the counters or the health and the operational status of an interface, when you do that with NetConf, you get it back in XML and you know exactly how to find the CRC errors. If you make that same request with a CLI, depending on the type of device, you may get back a text blob that you have to go figure out what line and then where in the line is the counter number and what are the units and all of that difficulty in processing a raw text or a string output. By going to NetConf, now you get the data back in what's typically called structured data. And structured data means that I can process that in my code very effectively. Now, the one thing to know about, or one extra thing to know about NetConf is that it has kind of a younger brother called a RESTConf. And so NetConf was the first standard that came out to kind of be this programmatic interface for the NetConf or for the network. RESTConf came out just a couple of years ago as a new standard, which is built to be a REST API for the network, a standard REST API. Both NetConf and RESTConf use the same Yang models under the hood. So the same data models are available through NetConf or RESTConf. But with RESTConf, now I can send and work with what feels like a REST API. And many developers prefer REST APIs. They're very easy to get started with as they go through. we teach REST API functionality all over the place inside of DevNet because so many platforms provide REST APIs as they go through. So RESTConf gives us that nice REST API for the network that is a standard that operates very similar to how NetConf works because they're based on the same data models under the hood.